सो हेलो गाइस, माय नेम इज रोहित राय एंड टुडे यूनियन कैबिनेट अनाउंस्ड मिशन कर्म योगी नेशनल प्रोग्राम फॉर सिविल सर्विसेज कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग, न्यू नेशनल आर्किटेक्चर फॉर सिविल सर्विसेज कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग, कॉम्प्रहेंसिव रिफॉर्म ऑफ द कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग अप्रोच एट इंडिविजुअल, इंस्टीट्यूशनल एंड प्रोसेस लेवल फॉर एफिशियंट पब्लिक सर्विस डिलीवरी. पीएम लेड एचआर काउंसिल टू अप्रूव एंड मॉनिटर सिविल सर्विसेज कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग प्लान्स. Capacity Building Commission to harmonize training standard, create shared faculty and resources and have a supervisory role over all central training institutions. Wholly owned SPV to own and operate the online learning platform and facilitate world-class learning content marketplaces. Capacity of civil services plays a vital role in rendering wide variety of services, implementing welfare program and performing core governance function. A transformational change in civil services capacity is proposed to be effected by organically linking the transformation of work culture, strengthening public institution and adopting modern technology to build civil services capacity with the overall aim of ensuring efficient delivery of services to citizens. Recognizing this unique opportunity to drive citizen centricity through a competency-driven human resources management policy which aimed to assign the right person to the right role, the cabinet has approved launching of a national program for civil services capacity building with the following institutional framework. First, Prime Minister Public Human Resource Council. Second, Capacity Building Commission. Third, Special Purpose Vehicle for owning and operating the digital assets and technological platform for online training. Fourth, Coordination Unit headed by the Cabinet Secretary. NPC SCB has been carefully designed to lay the foundation for capacity building for civil servants so that they remain entrenched in Indian culture and sensibilities and remain connected with their roots. While they learn from the best institution and practice across the world, the program will be delivered by setting up an Integration Government Online Training IGOT Karma Yogi platform. The core guiding principle of the program will be first, supporting transition from rules-based to role-based HR management, aligning work allocation of civil servant by matching their competencies to the requirement of the post. Second, to emphasize on-site learning to complement the off-site learning. Third, to create an ecosystem of shared training infrastructure including that of learning materials, institution and personnel. Fourth, to calibrate all civil services position to a framework of roles, activities and competencies approach and to create the delivery learning content relevant to the identified FRAC in every government entity. Fifth, to make available all civil servants an opportunity to continuously build and strengthen their behavioral, functional and domain competencies in their self-driven and mandate learning paths. 6. To enable all the central minister and department and their organizations to directly invest their resources towards co-creation and sharing the collaborative and common ecosystem of learning through an annual financial subscription for every employee. 7. To encourage and partner with the best-in-class learning content created including public training institutions, universities, startups and individual experts. 8. To undertake data analytics in respect of data emit provided by IGOT Karma Yogi pertaining to various aspects of capacity building, content creation, user feedback and mapping of competencies and identify areas for policy reforms. A public human resource council comprising of select union minister, chief minister, eminent public HR practitioners, thinkers, global thought leaders and public service functionaries under the chairmanship of Honorable Prime Minister will serve as the apex body for providing strategic direction to the tasks of civil services reform and capacity building. To cover around 46 lakh central employees, a sum of ₹510.86 crore will be spent over a period of 5 years from 2020-21 to 2024-25. The expenditure is partly funded by multilateral assistance to the tune of $50 million USD. A wholly owned special purpose vehicle for NPC SCB will be set up under Section 8 of the Companies Act 2013. The SPV will be a not-for-profit company and will own and manage IGOT Karma Yogi platform. The SPV will create and operationalize and contain marketplace and manage key business services of IGOT Karma Yogi platform relating to content validation, independent protocol assessment and telemetry data availability, The SPV will own all intellectual property right on behalf of the government of India, and appropriate monitoring and evaluation framework will also be put in the place of performance evaluation. An appropriate monitoring and evaluation framework will also be put in a place for performance evaluation of all users of the IoT Karmayogi platform so as to generate a dashboard view of key performance indicator. It is also proposed to set up a capacity building commission with a view to ensure a uniform approach in managing and regulating the capacity building ecosystem on collaborative and co-sharing basis. The role of commission will be as under: to assist the Prime Minister Public Human Resource Council in approving the annual capacity building plan, to exercise functional supervision over all central training institutions dealing with civil services capacity building, to create shared learning resources including internal and external faculty and resource center, to coordinate and supervise the implementation of the capacity building plans and the stakeholder departments, to make recommendation on standardization of training and capacity building pedagogy and methodology, to set norms for common mid-career training program across all civil services, to suggest policy intervention required in the areas of HR management and capacity building to the government. IoT Karmayogi platform brings the scale and state-of-the-art infrastructure to augment the capacity of over 2 crore officials in India. The platform is expected to evolve into a vibrant and world-class marketplace for content where carefully curated and vetted digital e-learning material will be made available. Beside capacity building, services matters like confirmation after probation period, deployment, work assistant, and notification of vacancy, etc. would eventually be integrated with the proposed competency framework. Mission Karmayogi aims to prepare the Indian civil servant for the future by making him more creative, constructive, imaginative, innovative, proactive, professional, progressive, energetic, enabling, transparent, and technology-enabled. Empowered with the specific role competencies, the civil servant will be able to ensure efficient service delivery of the highest quality standard. So that's it for now, and goodbye to you guys. Thank you.